In the United States, dozens of military vets are reportedly dying while waiting for health care. The scandal has many top government officials in the hot seat amid accusations of a cover-up. We get the latest from Brian Moore.
As many as 40 American military veterans may have died while waiting for care at this government-run hospital in Phoenix. Employees here and at other veterans' hospitals are now accused of trying to cover up shocking patient backlogs. It's a scandal that has reverberated from Main Street America to the halls of power in Washington, where lawmakers are demanding answers from the retired war hero charged with veterans care.
Any adverse incident like this makes me mad as hell.
General Eric Shinseki was decorated for his service in Vietnam, but as Secretary of Veterans Affairs, he's under fire for failing his fellow service men and women.
Could you explain to me, after knowing all this information, why you should not resign?
Are people, quote unquote, cooking the books?
I'm not aware, other than a number of isolated cases.
But there are now several reported cases of hospital staff trying to hide backlogs in at least half a dozen states.
We have more than allegations at this point. We have evidence, solid evidence, of wrongdoing within the VA system. It is potentially a criminal act.
Still, the head of an independent investigation says he has found no evidence of cause and effect.
It's one thing to be on a waiting list, and it's another thing to conclude that as a result of being on the waiting list, that's the cause of death.
That's a little comfort to Cindy Bordeaux, whose husband Jerry died last year of liver cancer. The VA botched the Army veteran's diagnosis, and he waited a month and a half for treatment.
My husband's last call to his VA doctor was, and I quote him, "I just want to know, am I going to die today or am I going to die tomorrow?" That was his last call to his VA doctor.
Little of this comes as a surprise to veterans.
I think heads should be rolling, names should be named, people should be losing their jobs and be on the unemployment rolls today.
Meanwhile, Americans who serve their country are fighting for the services they've earned. Brian Moore, Global News, Washington.